Hello and welcome to another MindBreeze tutorial. Today we will look at how to set up a MindBreeze standby appliance, including looking at setup scenarios, general setup, and maintenance. There are different setup scenarios available to us depending on the use cases we have and the license installed. All scenarios follow the same basic principle of a producer node and a consumer node. The producer will produce these indexes and the consumer will consume these indexes. The config is only applied to the producer node, which is then synchronized to the consumers. The first category of setup scenarios is the standby setup, also known as the active-passive setup. This is where we have two appliances, or nodes, but we can only search on one node at a time. Please note, it is not allowed to load balance queries between appliances with a standby configuration. The first variation of a standby setup is the classic producer-consumer scenario, where one node will crawl our data and the other node will be used to handle user queries. The main advantage of this setup is that crawling does not impact search performance and the end user searches do not impact the crawling, as we are using separate hardware for each. The consequence in this case is that if the producer has an issue and is offline, there will be no indexing or crawling until the producer is brought back online again. Search will not be impacted by this outage. If the consumer is offline, search can be enabled on the producer until the consumer is brought back online. The second variation of a standby setup is with both the producer and consumer crawling. The main advantage of this setup is that if one of the nodes goes offline, regardless of which, crawling, indexing, and searching can continue without an issue. The consequence of this setup is the increased number of crawlers, and that the search performance could be impacted by crawling and vice versa. The other category of scenarios is an active-active setup. This is where both nodes can crawl and index, as well as handle search queries, and you are allowed to load balance the search between both nodes. The advantage here is that you can balance the crawling and searching load between the producer and consumer, giving the best of both worlds for both high availability and speed. Please note, for an active-active setup, you will need a full license for each server. To set up a standby appliance, certain preconditions must be met. Firstly, after each appliance is racked and networked, the ports 8443 and 2222 must be open and visible between the appliances. Additionally, the host names of the servers must be unique and resolvable. Once we have met these prerequisites, we can configure this directly in the MindBreeze Management Center. As an example, we will set up the classic producer-consumer setup with an index and config synchronization, as this is the best practice. Firstly, let's log in to the Management Center of the MindBreeze appliance, which will act as our producer, or master appliance. A quick search shows us that we have some data indexed on our producer appliance. The same search on our consumer, however, shows that we currently have no items indexed. The end goal here is to connect these two appliances in a producer-consumer setup and synchronize the index and config. Now, let's return to the producer and navigate to Setup Nodes. Here, we can see the node of our producer. We can click on Add Node to add the second appliance as a consumer. For this, we will need the hostname and then the admin user and password. When we click Connect, we have now connected this node to our producer. When we change the Source drop-down menu, we are now configuring this node to be a consumer of the node given in the drop-down menu, in this case, our producer node. Now let's click on Save. If we jump back to the config of our consumer node, you will now get a warning saying that this node is now synchronized to the master appliance and should not be manually changed. As a last step, we need to verify our synchronization jobs for both the config and the index. To do this, let's navigate to Setup, Tasks. Let's first take a look at the automatically generated synchronization job for config. If we edit this, we can view more details and also manually run the job. Let's do this now. We can see that this config sync was completed successfully in the history. Let's now do the same for the index sync. We can see that it's in progress, and by expanding, this gives us more details about the running task. it is important that we check the option Enable Fallback to Query Services on other nodes. This is important as it will allow MindBreeze to forward client service queries to query services on other nodes if the consumer query service is not reachable. This adds an extra level of redundancy to the system. Now we can see that we have the same results as on the producer, as the indexes have been successfully synchronized between the nodes. Please note, if you would like to disconnect the slave node from the master, this must be done manually, and this can also be done with the assistance of our consulting team. To maintain the appliances, for example, installing updates, index reinversion, reindexing, etc., in a producer-consumer setup without affecting the end-user search, the best practice is the following. Firstly, disable synchronization between the appliances and disable the producers on the load balancer. Once they are offline, begin your maintenance on the producer appliances. After maintenance is complete, enable these appliances on the load balancer and disable the consumer nodes. Next, you should re-enable synchronization and synchronize the producers to the consumers. Finally, re-enable the consumer nodes on the load balancer.